Let's now explain to ourselves, I guess you could say, a more formal communication of the integral test. Integral test. So it tells us that if we assume that we have some f of x, if we have some f of x that is positive, continuous, and decreasing on some interval on, so starting at k and including k all the way to infinity, then we can make one of two statements. We could say either that if the improper integral from k to infinity of f of x dx is convergent, then the sum, the infinite series from n is equal to k to infinity of f of n is also convergent. And this is actually the case that we saw when we looked at 1 over n squared, but I'll look at that in a second. But the second claim that we could make, or the second deduction that we might be able to make using the integral test, is if it's the other way around. That if the integral from k to infinity, the improper integral of f of x dx, is divergent, then the same thing is true for the corresponding infinite series. Then this infinite series right over here is also divergent. And as I already mentioned, we in the last video, we already saw this in the case of f of x is equal to 1 over x squared. We saw that since the integral from 1 to infinity of 1 over x squared over 1 over x squared dx is convergent. In fact, it equals 1. Because of that, we were able to say that the sum from n is equal to 1 to infinity of 1 over n squared is also convergent. And now we can see an example where we go the other way. For example, we know that this integral, let me write the integral down. Let's start with this integral. From 1 to infinity, not of f of x is equal to 1 over x squared, but let's say that f of x is equal to 1 over x. Actually, let me just write that down. Let's just start with f of x is equal to 1 over x. It definitely meets our conditions that it is positive, and let's say we're going to consider it over the interval from 1 to infinity. So it meets this first constraint. Over this interval, 1 over x is positive, it is continuous, and it is decreasing. As x increases, f of x decreases. So the integral test should apply. So let's see what the improper integral from 1 to infinity of this would be. So if we go from 1 to infinity of 1 over x of 1 over x dx. This is equal to, we could write this as the limit as t approaches infinity of the definite integral from 1 to t of 1 over x dx, which is equal to the limit as t approaches infinity of, take the antiderivative is going to be of the natural log of x going from 1 to t. We could do it's really the absolute value of x, but we're dealing with positive x's here, so it's just going to be the natural log of x, which is going to be the limit as t approaches infinity of the natural log of t, or I could even say the natural log of the absolute value of t, which is just going to be the natural log of t, because it's positive t's, minus the natural log of 1, minus the natural log of the absolute value of 1. Well, the natural log of 1 is 0, so it's going to be the natural log of t, the limit as that approaches infinity. But the limit as that approaches infinity is just going to be unbounded. This is going to go to infinity. This right over here is divergent. So this right over here is divergent. So this is divergent. And because this is divergent, we can then say by the integral test, we can then say the integral test, once again, our function over this interval, positive, continuous, decreasing, we saw that this improper integral right over here is divergent. And then by the second point of the integral test, we can say, therefore, and I haven't rigorously proved it yet, but hopefully I gave you a good intuitive justification in the previous video, that the integral, that the infinite series from n equals 1 to infinity of 1 over n, which is the harmonic series, that this is also divergent. So we've already shown that the harmonic series is divergent using that very beautiful, elegant proof by Orem. I think I'm probably mispronouncing his name, that used the comparison test. But just like this, we have used the integral test to show that it is also divergent. And once again, let's remember what the whole motivation of the integral test is. Let me draw f of x is equal to 1 over x. So f of x is equal to 1 over x would look like, do my best attempt here. So let's say that's 1, 2, 3, that is 1, 2. And so let's see, when x is 1, f of x is 1. When x is 2, f of x is 1 half, 1 third. When it's 1 half here, it'll be 2 over here. So it looks like this. So this is f of x is equal to 1 over n. And once again, we see that over the interval we care about from 1 to infinity, it's definitely positive, continuous, and decreasing. And if we look at this sum right over here, we could view this sum as let's do that. Let me write it down. So the sum from n equals 1 to infinity of 1 over n is equal to 1 plus 1 half plus 1 third. And of course, we keep going on and on and on and on. In this case, since we want to show it's divergent, we could say, hey, look, this is an overestimate of this area here. Let me be clear. So we have this area. We have this area in green, which is what the improper integral is denoting. So that right over there is the improper integral from 1 to infinity of 1 over x dx. Now you could view this as an overestimate of that area. So this one right over here, you could say that this is this one height times one width. So that's that block right over there. That's the area of that is going to be equal to 1. Then this over here, 1 half, you could view that as the area of the next block, of the next block. And so you could kind of view this as a left-sided Riemann sum, I guess is one way to think about it. And so this is going to be 1 half. Yeah, left-sided Riemann sum. So this is going to be 1 half. And then the 1 third is going to be this one. It's going to be this one. And notice, they're all the actual area we care about, that the improper integral, it's all contained in these blocks. So this is going to be is going to be larger than this. But we've already seen that this is unbounded towards infinity. This is divergent. So if this is larger than this, and this is divergent, this goes to infinity, then this must also go to infinity. So that's exactly where the integral test is coming from.